Top of the morning. Come on in.
All right, we're on our way.
Hey, do me a favor, take your shoes off, please.
Oh, sure. I'll kick them off first.
Appreciate it. I got house shoes on, so this is okay. If you had house shoes, you could wear those too.
All right, well, I'm, you know.
No street shoes allowed. Oh, man. Let's see. Y'all caught me in an unprepared state, so if y'all give me a second, I'm gonna go ahead and make up my bed.
Do you usually get up this early?
No, I don't.
Oh, so you got up just for BT?
I got up just for y'all. Just for y'all. You know, sometimes it depends. You know, if I'm in the studio late, I'm gonna get my rest, I'm gonna take my time. But if I just have a restful night and I go to sleep early, I'll get up real early sometimes, work out, you feel me? But that wasn't one of them nights last night.
We was
in the studio.
Well, tell me what else we got on the menu for the morning.
Man, you know what? When I get up, I like to fill my stomach with something healthy, you know? So I'm gonna go ahead and make me a smoothie if y'all don't mind.
So D-Smoke, I'm a fan. Tell me about the first time you heard yourself on the radio.
The first time I heard myself on the radio, it wasn't my song. It wasn't me rapping, you know? I wrote a song for Jaheim years back called Never. And so I was on Manchester. No, I was on Crenshaw and 104th driving through Inglewood. And they played my song, the song that I had wrote. And it was the first time I heard it. I think KJLH played it. And I stopped in traffic and then I looked up. It was a dude next to me. I was like, turn to 102.3. And he was like, what? I was like, this is my song, I wrote it. And then he was like, you did this? He was an older dude. He was like, you did this? He's like, all right. You know, so I was just super proud.
Okay, so if you had the opportunity to do a collaboration with anybody, dead or alive, who would it be?
You know what? I believe, and I have good reason to believe, that I am on the verge of doing a collaboration with my favorite artist of all time, Stevie Wonder. Like, we've been talking, and I couldn't be more excited to be having conversations with Stevie Wonder about music. So that's my number one, and that's about to be a reality. I know y'all probably don't need me knocking on the thing, but this is how I get my peanut butter out. This is a taste tester for you.
All right, I'm doing it. You got this. So then what's the rest of your morning looks like?
Well, this morning, I gotta open a package. So I gotta find my blade. We're gonna go this way. Grab my little package. Because somebody sent me something special they was thinking of me. So we're gonna see what we got here. Do not be alarmed. I know what I'm doing. That sounds like something somebody say before they cut themselves. But I ain't gonna cut myself.
What's the most important piece of advice you've ever been given?
The best piece of advice. I mean, they're kind of the same piece of advice said in two different ways. My uncle told me, keep going. And then Vin Diesel said, because I met Vin Diesel.
Wait a minute, you just dropped that on us real quick. So Vin Diesel, huh?
I met Vin Diesel at Tyrese's house.
Okay,
yeah, so
you just
Vin
gave
Diesel
two
said,
jobs.
You can make mistakes. Matter of fact, you're supposed to make mistakes. Mistakes are good. Because that means you're going through the process of growing and arriving at that point where you know yourself and what you're there to do. Okay, what's this right here? Hey, we got the Young D Smoke hoodie popping. It looked like a large. This is a perfect size for me. We're gonna go ahead and throw that out right there so that when I get out here, I know what I'm gonna wear already. And then, you know when it's got two threes all over the paper? You already know it's gonna be some J's. But it's the customs. Hey.
What's the card say?
The card says, greetings from Jakarta, Indonesia. I hope you dig what I made for you, bro. Also hoping that we can keep this opportunity going between us. It's simply an honor for me to be able to make these kicks for you. YA, yeah. Oh, and congrats, by the way, on the 2 Grammy nominations.
you. That's dope.
Hope you win them, dude. Don't forget to include us in your tags at SCHF_customs and Lab X. Lab X gave me these. Let's see what they did. Ooh. The young snake skins. No animals were harmed in this process.
So you're a sneakerhead. Are you a sneakerhead?
I wouldn't say I'm a sneakerhead, but I can appreciate a good pair of kicks. Especially these, they got the young D-Smoke signature on there. You know, so it's love, that's love.
Tell me about a fan moment you had. Has there ever been a point where you met somebody where you were like, oh damn, I just met such and such?
I met T.I. at the end of Rhythm and Flow, like, cause you know, we wasn't interacting, shaking hands or nothing. So when I met him, you know, after I won, I was like, I met him on stage and I was like, hey man, you know, I was like, Stand Up is my shit, you know, one of his songs. And I feel like you ain't a real fan unless your favorite song ain't like the most popular one, right? So that's what I was trying to tell him, like, no, I like Stand Up, like that's my song. And he was like, oh yeah, for real. You know, so he was so nonchalant about it. I was like, damn. Like, you know, some people, when you get a certain type of respect for people, it's always tricky having a fan moment. So you kind of got to preface them, like, you know, you got to have some regular moments before you scale back and be like, all right, can I be a fan real quick? You know what I'm saying?
For sure. I knocked on your door and I had a freak out moment, so it's okay.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's love. It's all good, you know. And I understand, because I have my own fan moments, I understand that when I meet fans, that it's a beautiful interaction, you know, because they're genuinely inspired by you and what you do, what you stand for and all that good stuff. So that's, you know, I'm always open to that interaction because the fans allow me to do what I love for a living.
Like, what's most important to you? Is it that you stay loyal to yourself? Is it staying loyal to the fans? Like, what things do you think about?
Most important thing to me is building a legacy that's based on truth, based on mastery of my craft, and being inspirational, inspiring people. Even Nip said, the highest human act is to inspire others, you know? When you inspire somebody, it's almost like handing somebody a piece of life, you know, because people live at different degrees, right? Some people are alive, but inside it's just so much that they've lost and so much that they're, in a sense, so many pieces of themselves that are dying. But when you inspire them, it's like lighting that fire again and giving them a little piece of life. So I always want to inspire through music, uplift through music. And in the process, you know, put my family in a position to be, you know, to not have a certain type of stress, you know, not have all these worries, you know. So that's what I want to do. When I leave this earth, when I leave this game, whatever it is, I want the people to be able to say, you know, he inspired so many people. And his family is solid, they good, you know, they well off.
So you rep real hard for the West Coast, you rep real hard for Inglewood. Explain that to me.
Man, Inglewood is home. I growing up in Inglewood, I caught the bus everywhere. You know, I caught the bus everywhere. Caught that 115 down Manchester. I mean, people who grew up in LA, they know that you don't take things for granted growing up in Inglewood or LA or Compton or Watts, Gardena, Hawthorne, any of those places. When you catch the bus, you're aware of your surroundings. You know, that car pull up and they might just be pulling in the parking lot where you at to, you know, get a donut, pick up some coffee. But to you, it's like, all right, I don't know who this is, what they gonna be on. Like, you watching and you really just trying to mind your business. But, you know, a lot of times you ready for the exit. Like, you looking for, like, your way out in case something happens. Just in case. So that was one of the things that Inglewood gave me, but Inglewood is beautiful. You know, I always tell people, like, if you only listen to rap music, you're gonna be terrified stepping in Inglewood. And it's not so much about being scared, it's just about being cautious and being and vigilant. I'm gonna get a workout in. Yesterday, I did some lunges and some burpees and some mountain climbers.
You real good about today. Your fitness and your health?
Oh, yeah, I'm about that. I'm about that life, as you can see by my smoothie, you know. And then later, I'm gonna make some music, you know. So I actually got a busy day. Y'all call me super early, so it's been real. It's been fun. It's too early for this shit. Peace.
You putting us out?
Y'all gotta bounce.
Like you putting us out? Putting us out?
I'm
like,
putting. Yeah. Let me lead you.
But I mean, I gotta.
Let me show you to the door.
So I gotta put my shoes back on, right?
Oh yeah, put your shoes back on.
Okay.
I mean, you know, I know somebody with your size. If you wanna leave them here, you can do that.
She trying to.
I'm your escort today.
Okay. So
it's been fun. Blessings to you all. Thank you for visiting me. I might actually go back to sleep for a second.
Thank you, Smoke.
Yes, you're very welcome. Y'all have a good one.
You too. Yeah.